Hello, music lovers. Welcome to Friday afternoon, David Doucet's Courtyard Concert during happy hour. Hope y'all doing all right. How many weeks is this? 3 weeks, at least in New Orleans Parish. So we're still here, we're still alive, and we're gonna play. I'm gonna play some music for you and try to get our heads turned in a different direction than the problems that face us right now. I like to start off lately with the state song. It was written by Jimmy Davis, a previous governor of ours. I happen to know his nephew. Quite a character, all of them. Maybe you might want to sing along with it.
Shattered all my dreams. Oh, you're my sunshine, my
unique soleil. You make me happy when skies are gray. You'll never know, dear, how much I love you. Oh, please don't take my sunshine away. All right, to Jimmy Davis. And?
All the people we lost this week.
And all the people we lost this week. This has been a pretty bad week here in New Orleans, at least. I know everywhere else. When the governor comes on at 2:30 every day and tells us these figures, it's kind of intense, you know. We're going to make it through. The main thing is you stay at home, which is why I'm doing this. I can bore you or make you happy. I can do anything right here. And I want to thank, while I'm saying this, WWOZ for listing these concerts. It keeps WWOZ still going. Day before yesterday, I did a show for the Sidebar at NOLA. It'd be nice if more venues in Louisiana kind of got the idea how to do this. It is a little technical. We found out the other day. It's not as easy as it seems. But hopefully I'll be back. I'm going to try for next Friday, I guess. It depends on y'all, if y'all let me know. The PSA here is, we're going to talk about, everyone is out of work right now. We all know that. And of course, the United Way is a huge organization. And each major city in Louisiana, and I guess across the country, has its own chapter. So I was asked by Chef Pat Mould in Lafayette, quite popular and famous chef there, if I would make an announcement for the United Way of Acadiana, Feed the Envie, and it has to do with all the workers, the hospitality workers, the restaurants, the chefs, the waiters, and so forth, that perhaps they're probably taxed out, you know. But, you know, the link is here on the screen, I think. Also, by the way, I have a tip jar. Thank you, Michael Burke. I've already seen that pass through my phone here. No one is obligated to tip, but I do appreciate it because I am a musician, and guess what? I'm out of work. So, I have, and an update here. You know, a lot of people, you know, they ask if you can file unemployment. It's not as easy as it seems. I have a few friends that have had difficulty. Fortunately, being a musician, we have a couple of venues. One is, of course, locally for the state of Louisiana. Is the Jazz Fest organization, the Jazz and Heritage Festival. They have a grant right now, and they're working on getting more. And basically, that's important. And also the Grammy organization, which is trying to increase its footprint in Louisiana to get more artists to play music and send recordings so that they have an opportunity to maybe be nominated for a Grammy and might even win. They have a group, an outfit called Music Hairs. And although it might be a little technical to fill out all these applications, you know, ask your friends. You can ask me. Ask Reed Wick. He's on Facebook, and he's a member of both, the Jazz Fest and them. So there might be some help there. So that's what we always think about, is how we help each other in times of need. And that's enough PSA for now. It is happy hour, and I will take a drink.
Oh, that's a little,
and I have a little snack mix here I got from a place called Mona's in New Orleans. It's the samurai mix, I think. It is 5 o'clock.
It's happy hour.
It is,
man.
Happy hour. This is a song that I like to do. It's by a guy named Austin Pete. It's heavy in a set that I do on Mondays at the Columns with Al Tharp. The song is called Chère Joue Rose, which means pretty rosy jowls. But in real English, it means pretty rosy cheeks. It's a song about a guy who, he's got a date. I have a theme here we're coming up to, real serious, okay? The guy's got a date, and so he bathes, he shaves, he cleans up, and guess what? He's late for the date. And it really worries him so much, he's afraid that she's going to break the date. And of course, she does not. So here we go. The nice thing, the interesting thing about this song is it sounds like two songs in one, which very possibly could be. Chère Joue Rose, which means pretty rosy cheeks.
Rose. Wake up, mon cher Montan. Maman, mais j'arrive des fois tard. Moi, je regarde en travers du close. Moi, je la vois sur la galerie. Jolie couronnée, dit qu'on était la seule de mon cœur aujourd'hui. Oh, tu n'es qu'à partir pour aller te chercher. Ramener avec lui, pas bien que dans chaque jour, à toujours du mensonge.
I just realized through all that, I still had my earbuds in my ear. I don't need them.
A little distracted.
It's just, none of us are, you know, we're all thinking straight these days. I was waiting, I had a doctor's appointment with my cardiologist at 11. I'm still waiting for that telemed call that hasn't come through. So I would assume that he's probably blown me off for the day. Thank you, Dr. LaLaurier, I appreciate it.
Called out on Facebook, man. Dude.
Sorry about the earbuds, but you know, they're really wonderful. You put them in there. I've had them on since about 11 o'clock this morning, so.
Reach out to Apple.
All right, so the theme of the day is getting drunk and falling in a ditch.
Yes.
People seem to respond to that theme, and I have a few. I guess we've all been there. Although this first song isn't really about getting drunk and falling in a ditch, it's leading the way. I played this the other day. This was a Ben Sandmel request. And it's a song that our version comes from a guy named Edius Nakan, who lived in a town called Redell, Louisiana, just north of Mahmoud. It's a song about a character. Who thinks he's a good cook, but he's such a bad cook. He makes bananas taste bad, among other things. He even makes a chicken fricassee in here, and it's so bad he knocks it over. But his biggest thing, he likes to dance in the dust to make dust fly. And he's got a little candy cart that he has for children, a little cart that he lugs around. And he knocks it over, and it just tickles him. He's what we call a bombocheur, and you know, there's varying definitions of a bombocheur, but I think he's a happy drunk. To not a happy drunk. And so it goes something like this. I think mostly we did this on the the Gitan Kajan album. I believe we did it on that one. Not absolutely certain. We've only recorded 35 albums, so it's kind of hard to to remember everything that we've done. When we did it as a group, we had Jimmy Bro playing accordion, Michael, my brother, was playing fiddle, and I just sang it, and had sang it without guitar. So we worked on it several years, you know, how to do stuff, and I kind of adapted it to the Hawaiian guitar style, slack key. Tune the slack key tune. So it's called the... actually, the first one is called the Tinega Tangerine. We are going to fall in a ditch. I just saw my list. I have a set list today, y'all. Okay. You never know from what I was saying. Remember that Hackamaro, that's coming next, but this first one is a song from Canray Fontenot, who is a great old-time Creole fiddler, black fiddler from Welsh, Louisiana, and it's a song, it's an adaptation of a couple of versions I put together, but it's called the Tinega Ton Jolene et Jolie Malat, and it's also called the Couli Roder. The Couli, a Couli is like a little yes. stream, and the song is about a guy who gets a date and he gets so excited. And he finds a little bottle of whiskey and gets drunk, and guess where he falls? Right in a ditch. Nez got ton joli. All right. A great old time song. That goes out to John Fole. He likes that song a lot. I actually saw a video of John yesterday that his wife Shelly took. John's sneaky, you know, I've known him for quite a long time. He was working out You Are My Sunshine on his Martin, so I would expect that to be in the next iteration of what John does. It'd be great if we could do it together, but we'll see what happens. This is the Hackamoro. This is the song about the bumbo show, the drunkard who thinks he's a good cook. Sailor Hackamoros, a capotecha, capotecha la fuchsia, les bananes sont pas mangeables, le candy a tombé, il était pousserie, allons dans ces moros, n'y a mis pas comme un, allons dans ces moros, mais je les pêche, allons dans ces moros. Manger des bananes. Mes pauvres moros, yon bambo chercha, mes moros, c'est une gâte de ménage. On a été chez moro hier soir, elle nous a fait ton fricassé, n'y a-t-il pas mangeable. Allons dans chez moro, mais je les pêche. Allons dans chez moro, pour manger des bananes. J'aurais pas été la typhise amoroucha, on n'aurait pas été de tout, non chez lui. C'est le hack amoureux à capotecha, capoté dans la poussière, les bananes sont pas mangeables. Allons donc chez Moro, mais je les pêche, allons donc chez Moro, pour manger des bananes. ditch here. This is from the Lomax collection. If you don't know what the Lomax collection is, Alan Lomax was a song collector. He and his dad came through Louisiana in 1934, and they collected a bunch of songs. This is one that we adapted and put on our L'Amour et la Folie album, our first Grammy-winning record. Way back when, in 1997, I think it was. I don't know. Maybe I should pull the Grammys out on the table. Anyway. This one is called Boudreaux, and it's about a guy, Boudreaux in this case, who buys some rotten bananas, and he proceeds to get sick in a ditch. So there you go. We're keeping with that theme. I think there's one other song after that that might follow that theme. Then we go into the English songs. Okay. Once again, thank you all for listening here on via OZ who listed this. And also another PSA for the United Way of Acadiana / Feed the Envie for the friend of mine, Pat Mould, Chef Pat Mould, and the United Way of Acadiana, looking for help, donations for those in need. In this case, the hospitality industry. Des vieux bananes, les bananes sont tu pour dire, tu couches dans des grands fossés. Boudreaux, il est malade, il a acheté des vieux bananes, les bananes sont tu pour dire, tu couches dans des grands fossés. Boudreaux, mais quoi il y a, oh Boudreaux, mais quoi il y a, quoi il y a, quoi il y a, quoi il y a avec vieux Boudreaux. Boudreaux, es-tu malade? Dans les grands fossés, bananes sont tout pour dire, tu couches dans les grands fossés. Et Boudreaux, mais quand il y a. Des vieux bananes, les bananes sont du pourrir, couche côté côté avec ma femme. Ma femme, mais quoi il y a, oh ma femme, mais quoi il y a, mais quoi il y a, mais quoi il y a, quoi il y a avec Boudreaux. Boudreaux, es-tu malade, tu couches dans les grands fossés, bananes sont du pourrir, couche côté côté avec ma femme. Là-bas dans les magasins, juste pas acheter des vieux bananes. des bas nansons du boudir, du coucher dans les grands fossés. Pour trouver les malades, qu'elle achetait des vieux bananes. Des bananes sont du boudir, du coucher dans les grands fossés. Boudreau, mais quoi il y a? Oh, boudreau, mais quoi il y a? Quoi il y a? Quoi il y a? Quoi il y a avec vieux boudreau? Boudreau, es-tu malade? Tu couches dans les grands fossés. Banane sans tout pourrir, couche côté, côté avec ma femme. Hey, boudreau, mais quoi il y a? We have people in the yard. Thank you. We have audience.
Mm-hmm.
That deserves a drink.
Absolutely. And a snack. Everybody gets happy hour snacks.
Get a snack. I have little snacks right here. Does butternut eat that?
Nope.
You heard your name, didn't you? You want to try a summer rye mix? What do you think? not today. Okay. All right. Let's see here. Switch gears and go to some Americana songs. First one being a blues. This is from our friend Doug in Lafayette. If he's listening. He sent requests. I appreciate requests. I think they're wonderful. So this one is called Slide in Delta, and it's got a couple of things of significance here. Doug is an artist. He's a jewelry maker, and that's the name of his studios, the Slide in Delta Studios. Of course, we come from Lafayette. We're Prairie Cajuns. So to understand what the Delta is, I had to move to New Orleans in 1984 and be, figure it out. But I didn't know where it was. Hey, man.
Still don't know where it is.
Still don't know. I've never been up there.
Because New Orleans is nowhere near.
Someday, you can go visit John Hurt's birthplace. So anyway, the this one is a song that that we used to, when we were kids, we used to hum this and sing it and all that, and try to figure out the words, because listening to John Hurt, Mississippi John Hurt, it's not always easy to figure out what he's saying. Sliding Delta. Sliding Delta, run right by my door. Sliding Delta, run right by my door. I'm leaving here, baby, don't you wanna go? I'm leaving here, baby, don't you wanna go? That sliding Delta, run right by my door. Sliding Delta, run right by my door.
I'm leaving here, baby, don't you wanna go? I'm leaving here, baby, don't you wanna go? I'm a-going up the country, I ain't coming back no more. My suitcase is packed, honey, what you waiting on? My suitcase is packed, my trunk's already gone. Oh, tell me, baby, what in the world you waiting on? That sliding delta run right by my door. That sliding delta run right by my door. Big old Kate Allen, she's got ways just like a man. She gonna steal your baby every old time she lands. That sliding delta run right by my door. That sliding delta run right by my door. I'm leaving here, baby, don't you wanna go? I'm leaving here, baby, don't you wanna go? That suitcase is packed, that trunk's already gone. I'm leaving you, baby, what you all waiting on? That sliding delta run right by my door. Sliding delta run right by my door.
He also requested a song that, man, I hadn't played this probably 40 years, maybe even longer. I'm going to try a bit of it. I know why he picked it, because it's the month of April. I need a sip for that one. When I was learning how to play guitar, I had a couple of songbooks. One was Bob Dylan, and the other one was, it was a sheet music of Otis Redding sitting by the sitting at the dock of the bay, and the other one was some Paul Simon stuff. So I got into Paul Simon. Uh-oh, dog fight.
Butternut. Butternut. Come here. Good boy.
And this one is one that Paul Simon did on his, it's on Wednesday morning, 3 a.m. It's also on Sound of Silence, but also his solo album that he did in England. And it's called April Come She Will. We'll see if we can get through this. I told you, Doug, I had to practice. September, I remember
I love once knew has now grown old.
There you go. Woo, that was hard.
That deserves a beer.
That deserves a beer, like Marco Jimenez would say. So that brings it to another request. Doug asked for it. I was thinking about this one the other day, in fact. Everyone knows this song as a Doc Watson song. It was usually his encore. And fortunately, I was able to see him play live several times. And I'll never forget, he says, if I play this song, you can't talk. And of course, everybody would whoop and yell. And he would say, shh, over the microphone. It was like, and everyone would stop periodically. It's called The Tennessee Stud. It's a song that was written by Jimmy Driftwood. And I'll tell you what, Doc Watson, people knew about him before the Will the Circle Be Unbroken album came out. But after that album came out, this song's on there. It was a huge hit of his. And he played it, he said, probably about a million times. Let's see here. It's got 50,000 words, so I know that I need to I need a little help with this one. So let's see if y'all give me, maybe it's time for a PSA, huh? Once again, this is brought to you via the advertising of WWOZ, which is really cool. And they're trying to help out all musicians in Louisiana. And also, I have a PayPal. If you feel like tipping, there's a PayPal account, I think, listed on this screen. But also, this is for Pat Mold and the United Way of Acadiana, Feed the Envie, for the hospitality workers there. We all have a choice of charities or people we'd like to, organizations we'd like to donate to. Today I'll just have that one because Pat had asked me. He's learning the technology like all of us, and there's so little that we can do. You know, we're sitting around at home, so trying to make it possible to give us more to do, and that is definitely one thing you can do. So I'm going to thank y'all for that. So here, if I can find it, the Tennessee Stud with all the really great lyrics. There it is. Maybe I won't mess it up too badly. If Grady Walters still has a Facebook account, if you're watching this, this is for you, Grady, because this was the song every time that I sat in at the Milan Lounge on Milan Street for years, you asked me to play this. I played it on ukulele, I think I played it on harmonica, and I played it on guitar, but I never could remember all the damn words. Got them now, buddy. Along about 18 and 25, I left Tennessee very much alive. I never would have made it across the Arkansas flood if I hadn't been riding on the Tennessee Stud. I had some trouble with my sweetheart's pa. One of her brothers was a bad outlaw. I sent her a letter by my Uncle Fudd, and I got away on the Tennessee Stud. Oh, the Tennessee Stud was long and lean, the color of the sun, and his eyes were green. He had the nerve, he had the blood, and there never was a horse like a Tennessee Stud. We drifted on down into no man's land. We crossed the river called the Rio Grande. I raced my horse with the Spaniard's foal till I got me a skin full of silver and gold. Well, me and the gambler, we couldn't agree. Well, we got in a fight over Tennessee. We jerked our guns and he fell with a thud, and I got away on the Tennessee Stud. Well, the Tennessee
as he stood was long and lean, the color of the sun, and his eyes were green. He had the nerve, he had the blood, and there never was a horse like a Tennessee stud. Just as lonesome as a boy could be, dreaming of a girl in Tennessee. Well, the Tennessee stud's green eyes turned blue, 'cause he was dreaming of a sweetheart too. Well, we loped right back across Arkansas, beat up a pup and a whip up a paw. I found that girl with the golden hair, and she was riding on the Tennessee mare. Well, the Tennessee stud was long and lean, the color of the sun, and his eyes were green. Oh, he had the nerve, he had the blood, and there never was a horse like a Tennessee stud. Side by side, we crossed the mountains and the valleys wide. We came to Big Muddy, then we forded the flood on a Tennessee mare and a Tennessee stud. A pretty little baby on the cabin floor, a little horse coat playing round the door. I love the girl with the golden hair, and the Tennessee stud loved the Tennessee mare. Well, the Tennessee stud was long and lean, the color of the sun, and his eyes were green. He had the nerve, he had the blood, and there never was a horse like a Tennessee stud.
Yeah, you're right. Ooh, I hadn't done that one in about 35 years either. All right. Thank y'all. Well, I'm gonna, let's see. I was thinking some other songs to do, and people said, we like the cowboy song. Okay. This really isn't a cowboy song, but it's a Lefty Frizzell song. Marty Robbins the other day. Today we're going to do other people's Lefty Frizzell, maybe even Rex Allen. This one is a song that was an instant hit, apparently, and it looked like it was done in one take. And I'll tell you what, very few people can match the singing of Lefty Frizzell on this, but I'm going to try to do it. It's called The Long Black Veil. And if you're a real music aficionado, the secret of the song is how you say the S's. And I can't do it. I don't have enough gap in my teeth or something, because if you listen to the original and all that reverb they put on his voice, those S's stand out. So, as I said, there's a lot of numerology in Marty Robbins' Big Iron. There's a lot of S's, it's a sibilance in this one. So, here we go.
She has Grady on the phone.
Oh, yeah.
Listen, I don't know if you heard Tennessee Stud or not, but all the way in North Georgia.
Oh, I did that with finger picks. So it's called The Long Black Veil, very popular song. I'll tell you how interesting it was, because Lefty Frizzell, who died, I think he didn't make 45. But for a country record done in the late 50s, I think it came out in 59 or something like that, that they were playing a nylon string guitar on the original version of it. So. Ten years ago, on a cold, dark night, there was someone killed beneath the town hall light. There were few at the scene,
But they all agree that the slayer who ran looked a lot like me. The judge said, son, what is your alibi? You were somewhere else, then you won't have to die. I spoke not a word, though it meant my life, for I'd been in the arms of my best friend's wife. She walks these hills in a long black veil. She visits my grave when the night wind wails. Nobody knows, nobody sees, nobody knows but me. Scaffold was high, and eternity nears. She stood in the crowd and shed not a tear. But sometimes at night, when the cold wind blows in a long black veil, she cries over my bones. She walks these hills in a long black veil. Visits my grave when the night winds wail. Nobody knows, nobody sees, nobody knows but me. She walks these hills in a thin black veil. Visits my grave when the night winds wait. Nobody knows, nobody sees, nobody knows but me. Oh, nobody knows but me.
There's nothing there. Come on.
Woo, woo, woo. Butternut.
Oh,
he's so busy.
He's so busy.
He's so busy.
Let's get a treat.
Let's go get a treat, puppy. So I got a couple more for you. This is one that I did with Brownie Ford, who was a Louisiana legend, although he was born in the Oklahoma Territory. But he lived in a town called Hebert, not Hebert, Hebert, Louisiana. him and his wife, Cody, and I got to play guitar with him a lot during the World's Fair of 1984, and also did an album with him, which I hope is still in print. It's a great album, and it's quite interesting. And the only problem was that he was a little old. So he couldn't remember the words to the song. So this is a song that he did.
Alan, you'll show him the dog after the concert. No. They're asking to see the dog.
Puppy, come over here. Come here.
He's gonna have to jump up on you.
You have to jump up on my leg.
There he is.
There's my buddy.
Okay. So.
That's Butternut. He's the co-host of this event. He's my bud. And his buddy Henry's over here too. So we got lots of dogs in the courtyard. Staying away from the virus. Yes. All right. The song is called, it was called the Country Superman. His name was Rex Allen, originally did this song. And I'm telling you the truth. Dee Dee's losing her mind over there.
Sorry.
It's all on Google, trust me. Anyway. So the song, the deal is that it was also recorded by a guy named Al Terry, who had a TV show in Lafayette. And that was either before or after Lawrence Walker or the Aldous Rose show. I can't remember, or the Marinette show. But Al Terry had, he was in a, confined to a wheelchair, so his instrument was steel guitar. And he tried to make a run, a Nashville run. He was not as successful as Jimmy C. Newman. But this was one of the songs that he recorded. The only thing that I lack are the lungs to make this really deep sound that I cannot do. I just don't have it.
Cigarettes.
I'm not old enough or something. It's called Only a Hangman. To catch me a train, rode west through Missouri and into Wyoming, headed out to California to stake a gold claim. There's gold in the mountains, gold in the valleys, gold in the rivers, and gold in the sea. Fortunes are plenty for men to find them, but only the hangman is waiting for me. I met her at Clancy's, the cause of my trouble, a woman with beauty for all men to see. She fed me rye whiskey and gave me a six gun, said the fools do the digging, smart men work for me. There's gold in the mountains, gold in the valleys, gold in the rivers, and gold in the sea. Fortunes are plenty for men to find them, but only the hangman is waiting. She gave me her favors, and I gave her my six gun. We cheated most all of the miners in town. Those who complained that she dealt from the bottom were challenged to draw and were quickly shot down. There's gold in the mountains, gold in the valleys, gold in the rivers, and gold in the sea. Fortunes are waiting for men to find them, but only the hangman is waiting for me. I'm so tired of killing for love of this woman. The notches on my gun are 20 and 3. The next one I kill will be my scarlet lover, and that's why the hangman is waiting for me. There's gold in the mountains, gold in the valleys, gold in the rivers, and gold in the sea. Fortunes are waiting for men to find them, but only the hangman is waiting for me. But only the hangman is waiting for me. All right. That was a hell of a reaction. Excuse me. I didn't cough in my sleep. Sorry. I am outdoors. Looks like that's an hour has gone by. It's been quite fun. I hope whoever's out there, y'all had a good time. I'm trying to decide what should be the last song here. Maybe Rosalie McFall from my friends on the other side of Magazine Street, who always request this when we play at the columns. or yeah, maybe that's not a bad choice. I want to thank y'all for listening. This was fun. I may do it again next week. We'll see what happens. I'm fluid. Don't have that much to do. We're kind of sitting around like, you know, I get to practice a lot, which is fun. And I promise you, we're working on a Beausoleil, either live or recorded video we're going to do. The technology is something that we're working on, so hold on for it. This one is a song that I have been playing for many, many years, and I love it, and it's fun to play. And let's see where I'm going to do this. It's going to be here. I have to add a little extra to it. Find the banjo capo. Once again, a double PSA, there's a tip jar for me, but also I put on there a listing for my friend Chef Pat Moulds, who would like people to be aware that, of course, in the house, in the entertainment, hospitality industry, that they're out of work as well, most places. So here, there's a link there for the United Way of Acadiana / Feed the Envie. There, check it out. I forgot that the 5-string banjo capo makes it all out of tune. Cool. It's called Rosalie McFall, sung by Bill and Charlie Munro. And thank y'all for listening. Thank you for OZ for making this possible too.
Rosalie McFall.
I roam the wild world over, to cities great and small, till God prepares my home in heaven with my rose and leave me fall out on the lonesome highway, in a cabin low and small, live the sweetest of all over. Merci beaucoup, all of you.
Yeah.
Be kind to everybody's tip jar. Thank you to OZ's Live Wire, or the virtual Live Wire, whatever it's called. And once again, till next time, and go listen to some live music. It's all out there on the web.
Virtually live.
Virtually live. There you go. Merci. Au revoir. Yay.